ዘይ መገርሳ ፕሬዚደንት ኦፍ ዘ ፌደራል ዲሞክራቲክ ሪፐብሊክ ኦፍ ኢትዮጵያ ሳህለ ወርቅ ዘውዴ ሃድ ቶክስ ዊዝ ሄድስ ኦፍ ዲፍረንት ግሎባል ኦርጋናይዜሽንስ ሪፕሬዘንታቲቭስ ኦፍ ዲ ካምፓኒስ ኤክስፕረስ ዴር ኢንትረስት ኢን ወርኪንግ ኤንድ ኢንቨስቲንግ ኢን ኢትዮጵያ ሁልቃ ወንድሙ
President of the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia, Sahle Work Zewde, held talks with heads of different global organizations. The president received Melinda Gates, co-chair of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, Rita Roy, CEO of MasterCard Foundation, and members of the leadership team of Cisco, a multinational technology company. During a discussion held with Mistress Gates, female cabinet members were also present and held discussion on the ongoing reforms and shared their best experiences. Gates expressed her thanks for the warm reception and commended the reforms efforts in the country, according to Office of the President of Ethiopia. The President also received a team led by Rita Roy. The Canada-based MasterCard Foundation commits to supporting the initiative of creating 10 million jobs in Ethiopia within the coming 10 years. The foundation recently put $300 million towards the initiative. Similarly, President Sahle Work Zewde met with members of the leadership team of Cisco, multinational technology company. The representative of the company expressed their interest in working and investing in Ethiopia. Meanwhile, President of the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia, Sahle Work Zewde, also met with members of the UN Peacebuilding Commission at the National Palace. The team expressed that the reforms taking place in Ethiopia have made the country a beacon of hope and stressed the importance of taking into consideration national objectives in the peacebuilding process. The President also highlighted the importance of building on local practices and know-how in developing peace-building initiatives. The Peace-Building Commission is composed of 31 member states elected from the General Assembly, the Security Council, and the Economic and Social Council.
Speaker of the House of People's Representatives of Ethiopia, Taggese Chaffo, received a delegation led by Speaker of the Somali Parliament, Mohamed Mursal. Taggese said the visit of the delegation would further elevate the ties between the two countries. Fikadu Brahanu.
Speaker of the House of People's Representatives of Ethiopia has discussed with its counterpart of Somalia on ways of strengthening the relationships of the two parliaments in Funfune City. Speaker of the House of People's Representatives of Ethiopia, Taggese Chaffo, on the event said the Ethiopian parliament is ready to work with the Somalian parliament, adding working together can play a great role in boosting the two countries' ties to the next level.
Different development issues like that we work with Djibouti. Also, as you know, Djiboutians are also our friends and our brothers and sisters there. So people living in Djibouti and also in Ethiopia, around the border, Afar and Somali, they are all the same people.
Noting Ethiopia is undertaking different socio-economic and political reforms, Taggese underlined that the Ethiopian government is working with due attention to ensure peace in the Horn region of Africa. He added that the country is also ready to share experiences for Somalia in all aspects. The speaker underscored that Ethiopia had granted free scholarships for 310 Somalian students. Speaker of the Somalia House of People's Representatives, Mohamed Mursal, for his part, noted that Somalia is still not free from war and expressed his country's commitment to work with neighboring countries in order to ensure peace in the country.
International community have been supporting since 1990, have been supporting Somalia since 1991. I really appreciate Ethiopia is a part of international community and also part of African Union.
It was said that the discussion is crucial to strengthen the relationship of the two countries' parliament besides boosting diplomatic ties.
State Minister of Foreign Affairs Hirut Zemene held talks with the Ambassador of France to Ethiopia, Frederic Bontemps. Hirut commended France's ongoing project to rescue the rock-hewing church of Lalibela. Ambassador Bontemps, for his part, said a team of conservation architects from France is conducting a field research on the church and the reconstruction and restoration of the church would be completed as scheduled. He was also briefed the ambassador on the recent joint statement issued on the Grand Ethiopian Renaissance Dam by the Ethiopian, Sudanese and Egyptian ministers of foreign affairs in Washington. The state minister also explained Ethiopia's stance concerning the filling and operation procedures of the dam. Regarding the filling and operation of the dam, the ambassador Bontemps emphasized the importance of professional consultations by technical experts of Ethiopia, Sudan and Egypt and discussions among high-level government officials. The first slab of Grand Ethiopia Renaissance Dam's saddle dam, which is a milestone in the entire project, is fully completed. Leta Teresa has a story.
In an exclusive interview with Ena, Saddle Dam Civil Construction Inspection Head Engineer Girma Mangistu said the upstream phase of the Saddle Dam is now fully completed with over 40 million meter cube concrete embankment. The completed upstream phase of the Saddle Dam, particularly the face slab, covers an area of more than 330,000 meter square, he pointed out. According to him, the saddle dam is 5.2 kilometers and has an average height of 50 meters. Engineer Girma added that completion of the saddle dam's face slab will have paramount importance in accelerating the construction of the main project by shifting the workers from the saddle dam to GERD. He added that foundation treatment had earlier been accomplished to prevent any possible underground water leakage, and more than 30,000 plastic diaphragms have also been laid underground. Accomplishing the saddle dam's face slab with all the crucial components is now a milestone in attaining the services we seek from it, and most importantly, the way it is needed, he elaborated. Girma noted that the saddle dam, constructed in an elevation of not more than 600 meters, will have a pivotal contribution towards generating the planned 50,760 gigawatt hour power from GERD. Moreover, there was significant amount of knowledge and skill transfer during the construction of the saddle dam, the civil construction inspection head state. Excavation and clearing of the saddle dam started right after the commencement of GERD construction, while its face slab started in 2009 Ethiopian year.
Ethiopian Airlines Aviation Academy has graduated 384 professionals at the premises of the academy. Akilu Gabru.
Ethiopian Airlines Aviation Academy has graduated 384 professionals at the premises of the academy. The graduates are pilots, aircraft technicians, cabin crew, marketing and catering professionals. Out of the total 384 professionals, 16 are from Cameroon, Mozambique, Tanzania, Burundi, Sudan, Nigeria and Rwanda. The graduates are to say the following about their future career.
Ethiopian Airlines is Africa's pride, so I will do my best to promote the airlines group at all my destinies.
በዚህ ኢንዱስትሪ ውስጥ ገብቼ ደግሞ ሀገሬን ለማገልገልና ለማስተዋወቅ
I'm so eager to serve and promote my country in the aviation industry. It is also a pleasure to be part of this event.
After getting this knowledge, after the training, I'd love to go back home and work for my airline. Ethiopians will stay in my heart. They will stay my friends. I'll visit someday.
In his congratulatory speech, acting chief commercial officer of Ethiopian Airlines Group, Isaias Oldemariam, called on the graduates to exercise customer service mindset with the knowledge and the value they have acquired.
This also paves the way for the upgrading of the academy to aviation university level, for which the groundwork has already been completed. As an international civil aviation organization, regional training center of excellence, the academy facilitates the delivery of the ICAO courses, and we have just been informed by ICAO that Ethiopian Aviation Academy has achieved the highest number of delivered ICAO training package in 2008, for which our academy is to receive a prize at the upcoming Global Aviation Training and Trainer Plus Symposium in New Delhi.
According to him, the future of aviation lies in the hands of well-trained and highly disciplined professionals. Ethiopian Aviation Academy has contributed significantly towards alleviating the critical shortage of skilled aviation professionals through operating successfully since its establishment in 1956. It was learned.
The Indonesian International Food Innovation Exhibition, hosted from 13th to 16th November 2019, is kicked off. On the event, more than 50 members of the Ethiopian Purses, Oilseeds and Spices Processors Exporters Association have displayed their products. This will help to be connected with potential buyers. This is the effort of the Ethiopian Embassy in Jakarta and the association to narrow the trade gap between Ethiopia and Indonesia, it was said. That's all we have for now, man. Thanks for joining us.